I recently had a real estate agent tell me about a scenario with one of her buyers that had gone to another lender. They were doing a zero down loan, so that could have been USDA, Utah Housing, or VA. And so they thought that meant when they got to closing, they wouldn't owe any money at closing. Unfortunately, that's not what that means. So I wanted to explain the difference between down payment and funds to close. So your down payment is money that you put down. It's the difference between the sales price and the actual loan amount. Your funds to close is your down payment plus closing costs, which is your lender fees, title fees, appraisal and credit report, and then prepaid items, which is daily interest from the day you close to the end of the month. It's your first year's homeowner's insurance premium, and then a couple of months of taxes and insurance to start that escrow account to be paid in the future. So all of that's added together. You pay that out of pocket at closing, or you can negotiate with the seller and ask them to pay it. Now in this market, that's a little bit harder to do, but you do have the option of negotiating with your agent. But I just want everybody to understand that closing consists of down payment plus closing costs plus prepaids. Now, earnest money is always given when you secure a property. Usually right now I see on average probably about $1,000 earnest money. And that's either held by the real estate agent's brokerage or the title company, and that's a credit to you at closing. So you have down payment plus closing costs plus prepaids minus your earnest money, and that's where you get your funds to close. So I hope this has cleared it up for people. If you do have any questions, feel free to give me a call and we'll talk through your specific situation.